So we defined Bontoff factor we were doing in the last class. So what we have done, we have defined this I is equal to, so when I defined this, it was observed colligative property by calculated colligative property, which was equal to normal molar mass by abnormal molar mass. This is what we defined. Then last class we did some simple questions, like where I was just equal to the molecules which were coming, the moles or the particles which were coming after dissociation for a strong electrolyte we defined. And then I told you in all the colligative properties put I. Say for example, R and BP will become I into X of solute. Delta TB will become I into KB into M. Like this you just have to put I there. Now what happens in case if it is not completely dissociated or completely associated, then you have to use the percentage of dissociation or association. So that is what basically we have to do. So we define one more definition of I, which you have to remember, will be equal to number of particles after association, dissociation or dissociation by number of particles initially. Initially how many particles are there? And then number of particle after association or dissociation. So we will take this cases, two cases are there, one is for dissociation, one is for association. So this year also the question has come on association. There is some short example in NCERT, you'll be able to do after this, but let us see now. So suppose first case I will take dissociation. So dissociation. So in this, the molecules will dissociate now. Once you put electrolyte in a solution, it will start dissociating. The number of particles will increase. Now just one example, say NaCl if I do. It will give you Na plus plus Cl. This will completely dissociate. But suppose it has not completely dissociated. They will ask you, they will tell you, no, it has not completely dissociated. You will take, this is one concentration, this is zero. Initial concentration is this. Now suppose alpha. Degree of dissociation is alpha, so this will become 1 minus alpha, this will become alpha. What is alpha? Percentage of dissociation. Or degree of ionization, whatever. So, I will be equal to total number of molecules, total number of moles after dissociation will be equal to 1 minus alpha plus this is left 1 minus alpha, this is alpha, this is alpha. So this will become 1 plus alpha. Total number of moles after dissociation. Initial is 1. So I is equal to 1 plus alpha by 1. So I can write this alpha as I minus 1. I can write like this. So if you see here, alpha will be equal to I minus 1. Or I can write I is equal to 1 plus alpha. So just for example, just for the time being, just write like this. This I can write alpha as 2 minus 1. Why 2 minus 1? It will just come. It will become clear. So I can write like this. Now let us take another example. Say for example, MgCl2. Now this will break to Mg2 plus plus 2Cl negative. This is again 1, 0, 0. Now when this becomes alpha, this will become alpha, but this will become 2 alpha now. So I total number will be now, so I will be equal to 1 minus alpha plus 2 alpha by 1. So I will be equal to 1 plus 2 alpha. So I can write I is equal to 1 plus 3 minus 1 into alpha. Similarly, now you start doing, so basically, suppose if I take one more example, if I take say AlCl3, Al3 plus, plus 3Cl negative. So this will become 1, 0, 0. So 1 minus alpha, this is alpha, this is 3 alpha. Now I will become 1 minus alpha plus 3 alpha by 1. So I will be equal to 1 plus 3 alpha. I can write 1 plus 4 minus 1 into alpha. So basically, if your anything is dissociating and giving you n moles here, n particles. So you just remember this, I will be equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha. Please remember this formula, this thing. So in this case, I am getting two particles now. Na plus is two ions. So this is 2 minus 1. In this case, I am getting 3 ions. So 3 minus 1. In this case, I am getting 1 plus 3, 4 ions. So 4 minus 1. So formula is I is 1 plus n minus 1 alpha. This is number of ions. And remember, for dissociation, it is 1 plus something. So I will always be greater than 1. So I will always be greater than 1. So whatever you are getting, so for dissociation, your I will always be greater than 1. So please remember this thing now. So because of this, what will happen? Your colligative property will increase. So you are expecting the boiling point to be, suppose, raised by 1 Kelvin. So it will raise by 2 Kelvin now. So whatever you are going to calculate this thing now, so you will find that your colligative property will basically increase in the case of your dissociation. So I will be greater than 1. This is the case of dissociation. Now let us take one case of association also. Okay. Now this association has come this style. So here association will be, now be very careful. They will ask you, like you have to read the question very carefully, whether it is a case of association or it is a case of dissociation. So in the case of association, molecules will combine together. Suppose a molecule comes A, 2A molecules combine together to form A2. This is known as dimer. So this dimer is there in your question. The NCERT was solved example, this year also it has come, do it carefully. So two molecules will combine to form one single molecule. So you will get here dimer. Then you will get 3A, will form A3. This will be trimer. Then you have 4A, A4. This will be tetramer. Like this you will get NA will combine to form AN, which is your polymer. So here you are getting the two different molecules combined to form a bigger molecule. So the dimer, trimer like. So normally dimer only will ask you, but just general case we will do. So again, if you say 2A, will give you A2. Now, initially this is 1, this is 0. Now, if this has gone now, we see here. So what you will find now, you are getting A plus A. So now what will happen in this case, 2 are coming. Suppose X has gone. So I will get there. Now what you will start getting in this case, if this X has gone, each has gone X now, so what you will get is X plus. Suppose I am getting here, 1 has gone, this is 1, this is 0, so X has gone, so this will be 1 minus X, and this you, what you will get is X by 2. So again, I will be equal to 1 minus X plus X by 2. So this I will be equal to 1 minus X by 2. So I will get that. Or alpha you can write, so or you can write I is equal to 1 minus say alpha by 2. Okay. Here now it will be alpha will be degree of association. So you will get like this, I is equal to 1 minus alpha by 2. Similarly, if you say 3A will go to A2. Now this will become 1, this is 0. So 1 minus alpha and this will become alpha by 2. So I will get now I will be 1 minus alpha plus alpha by 3 by 1. So I will be equal to 1 minus 2 alpha by alpha. So like this you can find your I. Now in these questions, please see here what you are actually getting is now, if you see here, I is equal to 1 minus alpha by 2. So what you are getting in this case now, if you see, I is always lesser than 1. Because it is 1 minus this case. So suppose in the case of polymer, if I do it, so this will come out to be I is equal to 1 minus. If I generalize the case now, if I just generalize the case, so what I will get is now in this case, and A goes to An. So one, this is zero. So one minus alpha, and this is alpha by n. So I will be equal to one minus plus alpha by n by one. So I is equal to one minus one by n into alpha. So just remember this formula. I will be equal to one minus one minus one by n. In this case, it was two. So 2 if you put here, you get 1 minus alpha by 2. In this case, it was 3. So 1 minus 2 by 3. So just remember this formula and then you'll be able to solve all the questions. So now this is the relation between, it's the case of association. Be careful. So in this case, alpha is degree of association. Only thing you have to remember in the question is whether it is association or whether it is dissociation. Now they'll just ask you, either they will give you alpha, find I, or they'll give you I, find alpha, and then accordingly you can solve the question. So the NCERT question I'm sending, just think and solve. I'll send the solution in the next video. Thank you.